Well, we've made our way up to Boca Grande Marina, and what a beautiful spot it is. We just had a great lunch at the Eagle Grill, and nobody realized what they were getting into. It was new to most everybody on the run, including myself, to be here. And wow, what an impressive lunch. The food was awesome. The surroundings, the decor, the staff, everything was first class. And I think most people were surprised to see that in this quiet little island town. Meanwhile, just about 1:45, the weather's been chasing us all day and has not caught up. Touch wood on that one, because we know it's still south of us. We're now at the north end of the course. We're going to start working our way back. Next stop is Giuseppe Island for a private little gig there for about an hour. Hopefully the weather will hold off and we'll be able to finish the day off with a great day of boating here in the southwest Florida area. Meantime, about 28 boats made it to the lunch stop out of 33 registered boats. Not bad, but that does mean a few boats broke along the way. Here with the Fort Myers Poker Run as we check in midday, making our next stop at Giuseppe Island.
But of course, before we leave, we've got to do a little showboating, because that's what we do here at the Florida Powerboat Club. And that means it's time to do another poker card checkpoint here at the dock. Thanks to the dock master for giving Amelia and Christina a nice little platform to show off. You can tell they're having fun. They haven't skipped a beat. But it was time to hand out some more poker cards. And I don't know about you guys, but this indeed is one of the most fun part of the events for me, where we get the cards out and give everyone a chance to maneuver up to the dock. You know, you take your time. Nobody's going to have any scratched paint or any damage to their boat. As long as you're nice and chill, pull up to the dock and the girls have got the card ready for you. And just that whole exchange and getting that card, I don't know, it's just so much fun. You're always going to see that on a Florida Powerboat Club event. As long as it fits into the agenda, we're not going to make you guys go crazy and do it on every single checkpoint, but wherever we can, and put on a little show. Because what you can't see is a lot of people along the dock pretty much stopped what they were doing to watch it all happen. And I think it was kind of a thrilling little sideshow that nobody really expected to see. And I think that's what we need to continue doing with Florida Powerboat Club, because it makes it a lot of fun. And people watch us and they see that positive image that we're just here to have a good time. We're not out to harm any wildlife. We're not really trying to make ourselves look like we're better than everybody else. We're just a bunch of people in boats having a blast, and I think that's the image we want to portray. And I think that image is, you know, really continuously being well received by the general public, because they watch us and they say, hey, you guys are fun. I love to see you guys get together. They all know that it's good for the local economy too. And make no mistake about it, everywhere we go, we leave a lot of money in town, whether it's just a simple lunch stop where we bought lunch and maybe purchased a little bit of fuel, or whether we went into a small town and filled up all the local hotel rooms. The point is that we love to travel, we love the adventure, and we're willing to spend money no matter where we go to have a great weekend and make sure that we go home with a big smile on our face and a lot of great memories. So whatever it takes, I think you guys are willing to step up to the plate, and that's why I love you guys, and why you've been such a big part of my life for the last 25 years. And last but certainly not least, Roger and Pam Anderson and their 39 Nortec picked up the final poker run card here at Boca Grande Marina. And once again, thanks to everybody at Boca Grande Marina and the Eagle Grill for rolling out the red carpet and giving us a great lunch stopover. Time to get on board now and start rolling out towards Giuseppe Island. That's where our next checkpoint's going to be. It's not a lunch stop, but it is kind of a hangout. We are going to actually stop and get off the boats. This is something that was set up by George and Shannon Argyris, club members who knew that we wanted to go there because we had stopped there last year, and he sponsored a lunch party for us there last year. But this year it was more like a little hour and a half long stopover with tours of the island. They had golf carts put aside for us. You didn't even have to pay for them. The docks didn't cost anything. And this is cool because it is a private island, and people pay a lot of money to be members here and to use the facilities. And basically what George Argyris did was he signed us in as his guests, and he wasn't even present. He was out in California at the time, but he made it possible for us to visit there and hooked us up with all the staff. And they rolled out the red carpet too and made us feel like very welcome and made us feel like members. Now, obviously, it is an island, so to get there, you've got to be on a boat, and they've got a big marina to welcome us with all of our boats and plenty of space to dock everybody. If you're one of the island residents, you may come back and forth on a ferry that comes over from the mainland on Pine Island Sound. And we came over a couple of years ago and spent a weekend here with the Arduous family for George's 50th birthday. And I soon found out that the island has a very, very colorful history. And you wouldn't know it until you start cruising around and looking at some of the monuments and some of the plaques and dedications. And they even have their own museum of history, which dates back to 3000 or 4000 BC when the Indians lived here. And more recently, the Calusa tribe was the most recent Indian tribe to live here. But really, the major conflict here at this island was in the 1700s when the Spanish settlers and explorers had kind of laid claim to the island, but then along came pirate Gasparilla, Jose Gaspar, who, you know, obviously introduced a lot of conflict with the Spaniards, and there was a lot of warring going along with the island, and really colorful stories that come out of the past and the history here. But I would say that, you know, according to Wikipedia, the most recent and the longest running stint here in the last really two centuries began in the early 1800s when it was a small fishing village, you know, with about 60 inhabitants, run by a Cuban settler. And some conflict arose again that involved Indians and some warring and some battling and some death. And when the dust settled, it ended up just being taken over by a family that turned it into a luxury resort. And that pretty much has been, you know, its legacy from that point on as a private sort of a resort or an escape for celebrities. And you'll see a lot of the pictures, the old historic and nostalgic photos of, you know, from the 20s and the 30s and the 40s, where a lot of America's elite, Hollywood celebrities, and even a lot of government officials would come here to privately escape and go fishing and angling and, you know, just basically have a private weekend here on Yusepa. And that's sort of been its heritage ever since. So let's talk about our island tour today. And it was very well set up here by the management. They had golf carts parked out in front for us at no charge. We were able to jump on a golf cart. And that's really what you need to get around the island and tour the island. Some of the folks were happy to just hang out at the clubhouse and have a drink and a bite to eat and just really enjoy the ambiance. But some of the more adventurous of us jumped on board these golf carts and said, you know, let's go for a tour and see what this quaint little island has to offer. And as you travel further into the island, you'll see there's all kinds of cool stuff. There's another restaurant on the other side of the island. There's a golf club. There's pools. There's a nice, beautiful beach on the opposite side of the island. Very, very private. And you can just cruise around the island, you know, for an hour or more, take photos, and enjoy the scenery. It's late in the afternoon now, and we haven't got very far to return back to Fort Myers Beach here. What a fantastic stay at Yusepa Island Club. Thanks to all of the staff for rolling out the red carpet. We just keep getting treated so well everywhere we go. And that's what I love about this Poker Run event in Southwest Florida. Here we are back on the waterways. We had the helicopter sitting on the pad at Yusepa, so that worked out well as we catch up with William Ferensky here from Delaware. William and Patience in their 38-foot cigarette Top Gun. And I know they spend a lot of time boating around here, and it's their first event with Florida Powerboat Club. And I hope you guys had a good time, because you sure look good. I love how those uniforms match the boat. Gotta love that stuff, guys. These guys have really put on a good show, and that's the kind of showmanship we love here at the Florida Powerboat Club. It's one more time now with Lane and Chris Christensen from Texas in this big 52-foot Outer Limits Team Fastlane Mercury Racing 1350s. And she is one beautiful ride. Top of the food chain in the Outer Limits family. And I apologize, but we did have some audio glitches from the camera that was in the helicopter. And therefore, we're just running a music bed and a little bit of narration from yours truly. But We wish that we had the natural audio so you could hear the roar of these engines. Although I must admit that these Mercury Racing 1350s with their twin turbocharged QC4 platform are much quieter with the new exhaust and the technology they're using. So the boats just don't roar quite as much as they used to. I know this one does though. It's got twin Mercury Racing 1075s, and those are loud engines, as that beautiful rooster tail kicks up from those number six drives on Maiden America. Father and son team of Mark Headley and Spencer Headley. And dad always lets Spencer drive. You gotta love that. And that's why he's really good at it, because he focuses his attention and he knows how to handle this 42 fountain. And that is one beautiful 42 Lightning, I gotta say. In all of the fountains in the club, I would have to say this is one of my top five fountains out of literally hundreds that we've had in the club over many years. Another cigarette Top Gun, again, one of the most popular boats in the history of the Florida Powerboat Club, the 38 Top Gun. This one, a twin-step model, 2003 with Mercury Racing 700s, making it a fast ride. They clock in at about 110, 112 miles an hour with these 700s. You can tweak them out and do the chip and get a little more horsepower, but honestly, that twin-step 38 hull is not made to go much faster than 110, so guys, I wouldn't push it any more than that. It looks like Joe and his gang having a nice ride today. There's Bernie from Marine Unlimited in New Jersey. We met Bernie through our late Tom Healy, our good friend who we lost just around Christmas last year. And another one of our New Jersey teams, Frank Sr. and Junior Danucci from New Jersey, 353 Formula. If you don't believe me, just look at the front of the boat. It says that right there. See, Formula 353. But it is a good running boat, a 1999 model, as I mentioned earlier. Like to see these Formula Fast Techs still around. They're very well built. They've got a step bottom. They were very popular in factory class racing in the late 90s and early 2000s. One more time with this 30 Phantom, Joel and Gretchen Speranza from the Sarasota area. They're fountain owners, a Fountain 42, but somehow got their hands on this Phantom because it was running and their other boat wasn't. I don't know if they actually bought it or borrowed it or rented it or what, but it is a great little machine. And I'm happy to see that the seas calmed out for them a little bit, because when we saw them earlier in the show, they were getting bounced around a little bit. But now they're having a nice smooth ride as they head her on home to Homeport at the Pink Shell Resort in Fort Myers. And we're going to catch up one more time with Bill Munyon and his son Jack Munyon and their crew on this 36-foot skater called Team Aftermath. And I mentioned earlier in the show, Bill seems to be really happy with this skater cat. He's had a few other boats in the club over the last few years, but he loves catamarans and says that this 36 skater is just built so well. It's perfect for these waters and runs great with these Mercury Racing 850 SCIs. He's got five-bladed propellers on there, I guess herring propellers, and the boat, he says, is so dialed in, they can just crank it up to 100, 110 and leave it there all day long. And almost a sister ship to Aftermath, Crisis Management, another 36-foot skater. This one owned by Chris Ryder from New York, the Long Island area. Very similar in layout, obviously a different treatment on the graphics, and a little bit more power. The last one had 850s, this one's got twin 1000. They're Smith motors, and if any of you guys follow the offshore circles, you know that Brad Smith was the now deceased, the late Brad Smith, built a lot of high-performance engines. We lost him in a boat crash back in Lake Cumberland about 4 years earlier. But his name lives on, his legacy continues. The engine shop still does well and builds these big power plants for offshore racing and poker run boats. And of course, another catamaran, this one a 32-foot Spectre. Popular on these waters because they're built here. They were built here for many years, and the hulls moved around from different builder to builder, but it all began right here in these waters by, of course, Jay Pellini. You've got Daniel Munyon and Dad Ralph on board. This one powered by Mercury 300 XS Optimaxes. And you're going to see a lot more of these boats because the guys are just repowering them. They're repainting them and repowering them. This one's a 2012, but you're going to continue to see these Spectre Cats all over the waterways here in South Florida because a lot of guys in Florida own them. They're great running boats. They don't take a lot of power to go fast. Chris and Quinn Lamorque from New Jersey. Not their first poker run with the club, but certainly their first Fort Myers event with us. And I think that they would agree that it turned out to be a great event for everyone, especially the cats who really enjoy these calm bay waters. And keeping with our theme of showcasing all the cats, J.J. Vigorito from New York and his 30-foot skater. And this one is no slouch. I mentioned earlier that you're going to see more guys repowering from 300s to 400s, and that's exactly what he did with this skater. The pair of Mercury Racing 400Rs, a great performance package, pretty much bulletproof, run them on 93-octane fuel, and put the hammer down and leave it there and just hang on for the ride. That's essentially what you can do with this boat, and I think that JJ would agree that today is the perfect day for doing just that. Looks like the helicopter's gonna hold up here for a second. That's Chris Stevenson in the 32 Spectre, who just went off frame, making the bend here at this red marker in Pine Island Sound. And of course, there's Mark and Eileen Fisher in their 36-foot deep impact with the quad Mercury 400Rs. And I know he's just taking it easy right now, but this boat could almost keep up with those cats that were front runners. And it's one more time with the Wittenberger family here today in their 36-foot Sonic center console. It's a Roadster powered by twin Mercury Verado 350s. Last boat you saw four, this one you saw two. You know, honestly, you don't need to have a lot of crazy horsepower to have fun in a center console. I think they got this figured out. And here's a family who can really illustrate that, because they're into real hot rod boats too. But this one is so simple for them that they can go out and run it all day long and not burn a lot of fuel and have a good time. And I think that's really opened John's eyes to the whole center console thing. And let's join once again with Roger and Pam Anderson all the way from Texas, their 39-foot Nortec center console. Their first center console, and I think that came as a result of hanging around Florida Powerboat Club for so many years. They still kept their 42 Fountain Lightning. It's in Texas, but for the Florida runs, it's going to be with the Nortec. Now a complete change to a new style, a new format of boat, X-Racer, a 32-foot Doug Wright Cat, retired race boat, and with a canopy, of course. And he happened to notice the helicopter come up in the textbook move. He got the boat out of the wakes and into clean water for these great shots. And back with our official pace boat, Tron Scow at the helm, 42-foot Nortec Monte Carlo. And we're actually not really a pace boat at this point. We're more like a chase boat. We were one of the last to leave the dock, and somehow I think we recruited more people, so we were up to the normal 10 or 12 on board this Monte Carlo. Like I said earlier, this boat is capable of carrying 20 people comfortably, but I think it's just about right the way we have it now. You can see the two twins beside Tron at the helm having a great day. They're enjoying their first poker run with the Florida Powerboat Club, and I can understand why, riding on this very, very nice Nortec 42 with none other than the owner himself, the man, Tron Scow, at the helm. What could beat that? Up here nice and high now, looking down on the fleet as we catch up with David Berg from Texas one more time with this beautiful 43-foot Midnight Express powered by quad Mercury 350 Verados. Love the color, that deep brown metallic, a little bit of copper or something. I can't really explain what it is, but it's a nice color. In the sun, it just gleams with the metallic coming out of the finish. And then, of course, the black bottom and the red interior give it a very unique finish. And it's a really beamy boat, so it's got a lot of room and a lot of seating. You know, there's not that many people on the boat right now, considering how many it can hold. But thanks to David Berg for being a great representative of his brand, Midnight Express. And we're finally catching up with the other Nortec sponsor boat. This one seems to be running on two versus three. Got the center leg tipped up. Not something that you see very often with these Verado outboard engines. They're very reliable. They either hit something in the water, I'm not sure what happened. But it illustrates one point, and that these boats are so reliable, they're still maintaining 50 miles per hour with two engines, staying up on plane and going to finish the poker run. So that's why these center consoles with the outboards are the right solution if you want to finish every single poker run. Back here now with the pink shell, some nice aerial coverage as the helicopter does one final circle. And if you happen to notice one thing, guys, the rain has held off. I mean, it was the final leg, I think, as we crossed over the Gulf waters to get into the Matanzas Pass and come into Pink Shell, that we finally saw or felt a few drops of rain. But that was it. I mean, we went all day long. The weather was perfect. And now we're going to enjoy a nice sunset as we get ready for tonight's festivities. And by early evening, we got everybody together in the ballroom at the Pink Shell Resort. And what I like about that is that nobody has to leave the property. When you dock your boat here, you go straight back to your room. You have a drink or two at the bar. You have a shower, get cleaned up, and you put on your best outfit and you come on down to the party. And what's great about it is you don't have to leave the venue. So everything is all done under one roof here at the Pink Shell. And that's what makes this a great event. But what the really great part is getting everyone together, because if you look around the room, you might see some people that didn't make it on the run today. And that's, unfortunately, that's the nature of our sport, that some of these boats just don't make it out onto the waters, or they do make it out on the water in the morning and then they experience problems. So we can say that happened for at least 4 or 5 teams today, which translates to about 20 people or more that we didn't see through the day, but now they're here at the party on Saturday night. So I think it's so important that we get everybody together for this final big party and celebrate the powerboating lifestyle, celebrating our friendships, and maybe make some new friends along the way. Of course, with the projector up on the center of the room and the big screen against the wall, it also gives us a chance to really kick back and enjoy the memories of the day and see some of the boats from the helicopters and some of the aerials that we get from the drones. And it just kind of recaps on what a great day we had boating here in South Florida. I do want to thank the staff at the Pink Shell Resort, particularly the catering staff as well, for really putting together a nice dinner for us. And I think that's something that we all agree, and more recently we've had more dialogue about it with our club members at some of the events, where, you know, if we don't step up to the plate and put $70 or $75 or $80 on the table per person, we're not going to get a good dinner. We're not going to get a good experience. And I understand that these resorts do charge a lot for catered functions. And for us to all get together with 150 of us in one room to enjoy a private evening, we have to treat it almost like it's a wedding. And, you know, nearing that $100 a mark per person is kind of standard for a lot of weddings. And I think that we have to come with the expectation that to have that experience, to have that social setting, we're going to have to pay a little more for these functions. And I was happy that most of us agreed, and we had a nice dinner party that night for this event. As part of our structure for the evening, as informal as it might be, we do want to thank all of our sponsors, and we make a point of inviting all of our sponsors and VIPs for the event up, like Mark and Eileen Fisher, who represent both the Deep Impact Boats, Blackwater Boats, and of course offleaseonly.com, which is our automobile dealer sponsor, and they give us a Mustang every year for the Key West Poker Run. So they've been a big part of this club now going on 17 years, and I really appreciate their support. Another very important person that's been instrumental in the success of the club and continuing his support, Tron Scow and the entire team at Nortec High Performance Boats. And their involvement goes back to the early 90s when we first met Tron and Niels, and they were just getting their start, as were we at the Florida Powerboat Club. And we've aligned ourselves together all those years, over 20 years now, and you know, you can see the results. They've sold hundreds of Nortecs to poker runners and many of those people in the Florida Powerboat Club, and I think that that's a relationship that has been a strong one ever since and will continue to be so. The next part of the structure of our evening for every event is to award all of the People's Choice Awards in many categories, from Best Dress Crew to Sexiest Team, Best Paint and Graphics, Best V-Bottom, Best Cat, Best Center Console. And the reason that we give out these awards is really to show appreciation for all of those teams who have really made a commitment. I think that's the best word I can think of, a commitment to the sport and to their boating lifestyle, by taking the extra effort to order and build a beautiful boat and maintain it, to put on really cool casual uniforms that match the boat, that make everybody look like a team, and even the commitment when it comes to things like the farthest traveled. You know, some people are trailering hundreds of miles to attend these events, so we want to recognize that effort for those people who come so far to attend these events.
But they gave us a platform to do what we needed to do, and that was the stage, the poker run. So,
with over 35 poker teams to play out hands for, the girls got all the cards up on the board, and it was time to award our final winners in the top three categories. First of all, let's thank our Poker Run prize sponsors,
and we'd like to thank
Superior
Coolers,
Communications for their handheld Garmin GPS units, as well as the Powerboat Club event.
Handheld VHF.
We'd also like to thank Ocean LED for their underwater lights. Congratulations to Mark and Eileen Fisher on Team Deep Impact for winning third place. They attend a lot of events, but it's not often that they win poker hands. Second place went to David Berg from Texas, and accepting for his team, his son David Berg on the 43 Midnight Express. And congratulations, grand prize went to John Lasky from Illinois with his 36-foot Apache. And the coincidence is that John broke earlier today. He didn't even get a chance to do the poker run. But in our world, if you pay, you play. So everyone had a chance to draw cards and compete for the grand prize. What a fantastic weekend we all had. And we want to thank everyone who attended, from participants to sponsors and all of the venues and service providers that were involved in this event. We can't wait to return in 2018 to the Pink Shell Resort and Marina to do it all over again. I also want to thank our new FPC girls, Amelia and her sister Christina, twins from Chicago. And we even saved a little bit of time once the room cleared for a little stage time here as Christina sang us off. Thanks again for everybody. We'll see you in 2018.
Get up off of that thing and dance to do you better. Get up off of that thing and dance to do. Sing it now.